Lossless scaling has been around for a while now, but it recently kind of blew up because Linus Tech Tips did a video about it. Today I'm going to share with y'all my first experiences trying it out on the Steam Deck, even though officially it doesn't actually support Linux. Just in case you didn't know, Lossless scaling is a tool that's available on Steam, and it's actually really cheap. And as the name says, it does image scaling, but it also does frame generation. And that's why it gets so much attention, because it does a proprietary frame generation model, and it works with most games, even for those that don't actually support frame generation natively. People have been referring to it as downloading more FPS. As I mentioned in the intro, officially it only supports Windows. However, that's where the community really shines. Because more recently, this person made a compatibility layer that makes it work with Linux. And then another person used that work and built a Decky plugin that makes it super easy to install it and run it on the Steam Deck. So again, none of these are official, they are all community supported. The creator of Lossless Scaling even included a note there in the Steam page about it. And this video is not going to be in any way, shape or form a tutorial on how to install it, because like using the Decky plugin, it's super easy. But we will be testing it out so you can see my experience running Lossless Scaling on the Steam Deck, okay? So let's go. So, just a quick disclaimer here. I don't usually play very heavy games on my Steam Deck. The only one that I play that is a bit heavier, and it's the one that we are going to be using for our test today, is Dragon Ball Sparking Zero, okay? So, as I mentioned, once you have the Decky plugin installed, it's pretty easy. You just go into Lossless Scaling there. You can just click a button to install the compatibility layer. There's a copy launch option here because you need to copy and paste it in your game's properties for each game that you're going to be using with Lossless Scaling. There's a setting here to turn it on and off and change the multiplier. And there are a couple of other settings here that I don't think we will be messing with today, okay? So first, I'll leave it off. One thing that I would like to say about Dragon Ball Sparking Zero is that like the worst frame drops that we have are in the menus for some reason. We got like 10 for a second there, 28, which is far from ideal. You don't wanna get anything like under 30 FPS or maybe 45. Okay, now we're in game. As you can see, it's pretty snappy, works quite well. And it's, yeah. As you can see, it doesn't really go under 50 most of the time. It's between 60 and 50 FPS. Graphics, you can see that like most of the things are on low, and a couple are on medium, basically. Okay, so now I'm going to turn Lossless Scaling on, and you guys will see. So apparently the present mode makes a lot of difference. We're not using VSync for this game, and like the mailbox one seems to be working much better. So my Steam Deck is the LCD version. I'm not sure what's the refresh rate for the OLED one. The LCD version caps at 60 Hz. Anything higher than 60 probably you won't be able to tell. Since it's 2X, if the base game is running at 50 to 60 FPS, we're going to get 100 to 120 FPS with Lossless Scaling on, right? So during gameplay, I can't really tell much of a difference. Might be because of what I mentioned about the 60 Hz on the LCD screen, but we are consistently hitting like really high frame rates with Lossless Scaling on, right? Now I'm going to go back to the main menu, and we are going to make the graphics more demanding on purpose, kind of force the game to run at a lower frame rate so we can, but I'm going to turn Lossless Scaling off for now. Let's turn everything to medium this time. Okay, so now you can see we are pretty close to 40 FPS. I'm definitely feeling a little sluggish. You can see a little bit of ghosting on the screen for sure, but gameplay-wise is also pretty bad, especially since it's a pretty high-speed game, I would say. So let's try turning Lossless Scaling on. So instantly we're hitting like 80 FPS. I wouldn't really consider this playable. mostly because of the input lag, even though it says like 80 FPS there. The image is pretty smooth, so if this weren't like a fighting game, maybe like if it's a turn-based game or an RPG or something like that, I think it would be nice to play it with like better graphics and still achieve a good FPS. So I think the conclusion here is that lossless scaling absolutely delivers what it says it does. However, it's not like a magic bullet, okay? If you only care about FPS, it's great, but you really have to be mindful about input lag, especially on fast-paced games such as fighting games. It can make like a very noticeable difference, and lossless scaling can't really save you on that. Your Steam Deck needs to run the game at least like at like 45 to 50 FPS, I would say, for lossless scaling to like improve your FPS and still keep the input lag low. But I guess that's it for today. See you guys next time.